Right, now, Chargaps, part of being a good commentator is that you must be able to talk to anybody at any time. And, of course, you must be able to speak languages of many, many people. And one of the most difficult languages, Chargaps, to speak in the world is the language of hot women. Now, when I was young, I used to be very, very intimidated by a hot female. But over the years, and as I drank more and more whiskey, I often became more familiar, not too familiar with females. But what I'm trying to say is that you must be comfortable talking to hot females if you're going to be successful as a commentator. Now, if you look over my left shoulder over there, you'll see a lovely, lovely young lady who happens to be all alone here at Kirstenbosch Gardens. Now, Chargaps, I think if you want to cut your teeth, I think it would be a good opportunity for you to go over and meet her.
What do I say? How do I...
Chargaps, just be absolutely natural. Women love a man with a bit of sense of humor. You're not a bad-looking chap. You could try and make it work. So just go there, be natural, talk your natural game, and for God's sake, don't talk about rugby. This is the only time, Chargaps, when you are forbidden.
Hold my hair.
Yes, it looks very nice. And not a shade of grey, unlike me. Now be natural, just believe. Say I can.
I can. Okay.
You can do it, Chargaps. Go. How did it go? Looked like it went well. You got off on the right foot, did you?
I said that she had nice elbows.
Chargaps, you're an absolute fucking moron. Why would you say that to her?
She said then that I should get her a drink from the appetizer because she thought I was a waiter.
These are very, very nice blazers. She thought you were a waiter. Chargaps, can you do absolutely nothing right? I have to do everything for you. See, Chargaps, what you lack and what I have is a bit of self-confidence. And if you can get anywhere, how do you think I got where I am today? It's all about self-confidence. Now watch. No, Chargaps and I just happened to find ourselves at Kirstenbosch this afternoon and, well, we couldn't help but notice you sitting here all by yourself. Any reason that you come here and read books and look extremely attractive in the process?
Well, it's a beautiful day and I had the free morning, so I thought I'd come and lie in the sun and read a magazine.
And of course, you're not actually reading a magazine. I noticed it's the Canon camera manual.
Yeah. No, I left my glamour, so I've just borrowed this from a friend.
So you're intellectual as well?
A little bit, no. What a wicked thing
to do. Let me dream of. No, man, Chargaps, leave Alexa alone. What a wicked thing to say. You never felt this way. What a wicked thing to do. To make me dream of you. And I wanna fall in love. No, well, we moved out of the sun and we found some love in the shade, and well, it's lovely to be at Kirstenbosch this afternoon, and of course it's even more special to have a woman next to me, and consensually, I might add, I haven't had this in ages, Alexa. If you could choose one rugby player to shack it up with for the night, who would it be and why? Forget the why part. Just who the fuck? Who would it be?
Very, very good question.
Thank you.
I don't know the answer. I haven't really thought about it. But I'll be impartial and do an English one, so I'll do maybe Johnny Wilkinson.
It's always Johnny Wilkinson, isn't it, with you bloody English? Isn't it Johnny this, Johnny that? What about a 62-year-old commentator that was once, perhaps, a brilliant fly-half that never made it into the Springbok side and now looks like he's going to miss out on the Church of England? Not that I have sour grapes or anything.
Oh, no.
What about that, Alexa?
Very, very close. Very, very close second.
Yeah. You know, you can buy fish and chips, but you can't buy experience.